Steam Series, championed by your Southern California Toyota dealers.
In this week's STEAM series, our focus is science and math.
Yeah, KCAL9's Danielle Gersh has the story of a local ICU doctor who cared for COVID-19 patients before contracting it himself.
There was a lot of fear amongst healthcare workers.
Dr. Oren Friedman is a pulmonary and critical care specialist at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center. During the earliest days of the COVID-19 pandemic here in LA,
Cedars-Sinai was hit harder and with larger volume than many of the other local hospitals.
And it was Dr. Friedman's job to do what he could to keep COVID patients alive and breathing. The risk was high.
Not only do we worry about whether we were going to get sick, but we worried whether or not if we got sick, how sick would we get and would we be able to survive?
On March 20th, Dr. Friedman started feeling achy.
That weekend, I had a colleague cover for me, which was the first time, honestly, ever in my career that I've ever not gone into work.
He got tested for COVID-19. 4 days later,
I found out that my results were positive. It's possible that I got infected through a healthcare worker, but certainly it's also just as very possible that I did get sick working in the intensive care unit.
It was a terrifying time.
I saw patients not surviving my age.
Dr. Friedman did recover. Then he volunteered in one of New York City's most overwhelmed COVID wards.
But the New York experience was like taking years of understanding this novel disease and packing it all into a month of time where you learn so much about the patterns because you simply have the volume to be able to illustrate even the rarer patterns. A tremendous amount of clot formation that patients with COVID-19 have.
Another thing he learned,
the PPE that we were wearing was working, that healthcare providers were being exposed to an incredible volume of patients, but that overall the healthcare provider rate of turning positive for COVID-19 was low.
Of all the STEAM disciplines, Dr. Friedman relies most on science and math, what he calls the scientific approach.
It's sometimes removing the gut instinct and the emotional approach. The scientific approach is mathematical, it's trial-based.
To students struggling, know that you're not alone.
Science and math is hard. Many of us as physicians struggled with our math classes in high school and chemistry classes in college.
But on the other end of all that schooling,
there is so much more that goes into being a good doctor.
Most importantly, personal connections. As the COVID pandemic wears on and critically ill patients and their families continue to come through,
I've at times let them know that I had, you know, COVID-19 and that I will do my best. I'm going to try everything to see if I can get their loved one to pull through it.
And for more on STEAM careers, just go to cbsla.com/steam.